Hello and welcome to Newmarket Public Library's introduction on Adobe Illustrator. Today we will be using Adobe Illustrator to trace out an image for use with the vinyl cutter. Today I will be using an example image of the Hyrule Shield. I've picked this picture because it is very, very hard for the vinyl cutter program to make the lines because of the texture that's across the shield, as well as the background mixing in with the shadow. The goal is that we will be able to easily have the cutout shape of the shield as well as all the other elements inside of the shield for use in multicolored vinyl cutting. The first thing that you'll need to do if you haven't already gotten an image is find your image and drag it in. So I've already dragged mine in and created a new layer called Shield Background. Once you've dragged yours in, you can rename your layers so that you can easily keep track of them. But to start, we are going to create a new layer. And then I'm going to call this layer Shield Outer. Inside of this layer, we're going to trace the outside of the shield. I suggest on your image, you start with the outside details as well, and then work your way in. So with the shield outer layer selected by clicking on it, I'm going to close that out so it's out of the way, and then I'm going to use the pen tool. If you've never used the pen tool before, the pen tool will allow you to click on a spot to put a point, and then you can draw shapes using it. So if I click around, you can see I'm drawing this shape. You can click the final point in order to close the shape off. However, there's another important thing to know about the pen tool. If you click and then drag, you'll have handles coming out of the point. So if I click and then drag, you can see that the next point follows that line. And it's only the left point here that is affecting that. Otherwise, you can see that if I click and hold, that next point is going to affect it. But now if I hold down the Alt or Option key, depending on if you're on Mac or PC, if I hold that key down, it'll move this one around, and you can see it's not affecting that line. This is going to affect our next line. So if I move this up here, you'll see that the next point is going to try and follow that handle. And so we're going to use this tool in order to outline each element of the shield. So I'm going to go ahead and delete those shapes that I was making and select the pen tool once again. Before I start drawing, I'm also going to make it so that there's no infill color, and I'm going to make it so there's no stroke on my image object. So now I can draw and trace, and there's not going to be anything covering up my work. Afterwards, I will go back and I will add the individual colors and all of that jazz onto our lines. So I'm going to start with the top. I'm going to go ahead and make the shape of the shield. So here I've deselected this point so that I could edit this point by holding down Command or Control, depending on if you're on Mac or PC, and then double clicking the point. And then that allows me to edit that point as opposed to the next point, because I wasn't satisfied with the handle. So now to get back to this point, I can once again hit Command or Control and then double click it once again. All right, I now have a good outline of my shield here. So now I'm gonna open up my layer. I'm going to go ahead and open up the color. And because my goal is to be able to print this on the vinyl cutter, I'm going to be using easily distinguished colors for each of the separate things that I want printed. So for your purposes, you may not have to do that, and you could make it whatever color you wanted and make it an accurate color. If you were to make it an accurate color, you would end up kind of with a flat icon appearance, which can look very nice for a lot of designs. So for me though, I'm going to go ahead and just select a black color for the infill. Next, I'm going to open up my layer. I'm going to hide my shield outer layer so that I can work on the next detail. To work on the next detail, I'm going to make a new layer. And I'm once again going to be working from the inside out. So I'm going to call this layer blue inner. And I'm going to use it to trace this blue outline here. I'm not going to be tracing these shapes of the shield for this tutorial, because on the vinyl cutter, I'm not going to have those shapes cut out. I just want the solid shield outline. If you were to do those, you could make a new layer and do all of them on the same one. Anyways, moving on with the blue inner layer. I'm going to hide the layer view once again by clicking that. And I'm going to open up the pen tool, if I don't already have it selected, once again. And I'm going to trace it the same way I did before. So now I've outlined the shield's blue inner part, so I'm going to go ahead and change the infill color to a blue. Again, for my purposes, the color isn't too important. For yours, if you need it to be a very specific color that the image already had, you could do something like this. You could use the eyedropper tool, and then click the color on the shield that you want. So say I wanted it to be that blue, or say I wanted it to be that black. You can change the color using that. Alright, so now that I've got the blue and the black looking pretty good, I'm going to go ahead and hide those once again, create a new layer, and this one I'm going to do the Triforce with, which is that inner triangle shape. For this one I'm going to be needing to use multiple shapes, but they're all going to be the same size as each other. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the pen tool to outline one of the triangles, like so. I'm going to zoom in by holding the Alt key and scrolling in. And I'm just going to do one of the triangles, like so. Then I'm going to edit the path so that it is a perfect triangle. And change the color. A nice yellow. And then because they're all the same shape, I can copy and paste this piece onto the other two and then line them up perfectly with the snapping feature that Illustrator has. Actually, before I copy it, that wasn't in the center there. So I'm going to edit that point once again. Drag it out of the way just so that there's no snapping interference. I'm going to line it up in the center with it. So you'll see that it's actually telling me that if I put it there, it's directly in the middle of the shape. That will help me line it up later. So next, I'm going to copy it. You can't see it on screen, but I'm hitting File. Or apologies, I'm hitting Edit. And then Copy, if you're looking through the menus. Or you can do Command or Control C. And then you can do Command or Control V to paste. Or once again, if you don't want to remember the key command, you can go in through Edit and paste. So now I'm going to select the selection tool. I'm going to use it to drag this around until it's in a spot that I'm satisfied with. To make this easier on myself so that I'm not tricked by where I'm actually dragging it, I'm going to hide the background layer. So that's just the triangles. So I'm going to drag it. And you can see that it's telling me that it's intersecting. And then I can make sure that those points are lined up perfectly. Then I can copy this once again and paste it once again. And once again, drag it so that it's snapped into place. Here you can see, because of that snapping feature, we have a perfect shape of triangles. I'm going to show my layers again. And you can see that it didn't line up all that well with the other image. But that's okay, because we're just looking for a good final product. And because of the tilt of this shield, actually, it will distort the way that the triangles look, whereas we're going for a nice flat look. So, here's what it looks like so far. Now that I've got this out here, I've noticed that my inner blue has a little bit of a funky bit at the top here. So I'm going to go ahead and select this point. I'm going to try and get it into a position I'm more satisfied with. I'm once again using the Alt key and the scroll wheel to zoom in. I'm going to drag it out of the way once again so there's no snapping. I'm going to drag it to a position I'm happy with. Right there. And I think that's a little bit better. I'm going to hide those layers again. Next, I need to make a layer for all of these shapes. So I'm going to go ahead and hit New Layer. And I'll just call this red, since it'll hold all the red parts. I'm going to hide the layer. Once again, use the Select tool. And I'm going to select a shape for each of these. However, due to the complexity of the shape, I'm actually going to do a cool little trick. So I'm only going to do half of it, and then I'm going to copy it over and I'll mirror it. So I'll show you guys how to do that once I've got it all done on the one side. Before I do the other parts of it, I'm going to show you how to do the mirroring. So I'm going to hit the selection tool and select this path. Once again, I'm going to copy and paste it through the methods that we used previously. And on this new shape, I'm going to right click it, and then under transform, which unfortunately is a little bit off screen for you guys. Let me see if I can get that on screen. There we go. Transform, and then I'm going to go to reflect. So I want to reflect it over the vertical axes, so that is what I'm going to select. If you wanted to flip it so that it was over the horizontal, you could select this box here. Or if you wanted to do it by a specific angle, you could even select that in here. I'm going to hit OK. And now you can see that it's actually flipped itself over. So I'm going to line this up as best I can, as best I can with the shape that's on the image. But the reason that it's not lined up perfectly is, once again, because it's slightly different on the image. But we know that this is now an exact mirrored copy of this, which is really nice. So I'm going to do the exact same thing to do this. As well, I'm going to use an incomplete shape around this half of the details on here. And I'm going to mirror them over and connect them to make one solid shape for each of these shapes. So I'll get back to you when I'm done with that. So the next thing that I need to do is I need to move my red layer above the shield layers here so that we can actually see it. We need it to be on top. So next, I'm going to go ahead and select. Oh, whoops, I accidentally added those paths into the wrong shape. So all I'm going to do is I'm just going to drag them up to the red layer again. So next, I'm just going to select all of them. Go to color. Oops, sorry, I need to select them using the select tool. So I'm going to hit shift, select, shift, select, shift, click, and do that for all the paths. And now I can adjust all their colors at the same time, which is quite handy. There. Now I've got a nice red. The last thing that I have left to do on my picture is the shield design that is here. So I'm going to once again make a new layer for those. And I'm going to go ahead and call it Shield Details. I always recommend meaningful names for your layers, so that way you actually know what you're hiding and what you're showing. I'm going to go ahead and hide the layer view after making sure that I'm inside my new layer. I'm going to go to the pen tool once again, and I'm going to outline these shapes. Once again, because this is the same thing as this, I'll be only doing one, and then I'm going to copy and paste it and reflect it onto the other. Awesome. So now that we have all of our details added to the shield, we can go ahead and put all of those up, hide our shield background. You can see we've got a nice final product here. So the cool thing about what we've done with this shield is because we've traced all of the objects ourselves, we're now able to size them all without losing any resolution. So right now we've got it quite big, but say we added this to a bigger canvas, we could go ahead and size these infinitely large if we wanted to. And you'll notice that it's not going to get blurry, which is really cool. This way you can take a blurry image and you can make it into a bigger one if you so choose to put on, say, a website, on Facebook. If you want to print it on the vinyl cutter, which is what I'll be doing with mine, it's very handy because if a picture gets blurry, I won't be able to actually detect any of the lines. The next part of this tutorial will be specific to the people who want to do final cuts. So first I'm going to go ahead and change this size back down to a manageable size within our canvas, like that. And on the vinyl cutter, I would like to print this shape out, but I want to do it in multiple colors. I want to be able to do everything that's in the same color as different parts in their respective colors. So I'm going to have a black color for these here, blue for the inner part of the shield, yellow for the Triforce shape, and then I want all of this to be in red. So normally the vinyl cutter is able to distinguish lines pretty well, especially with the way we've done our shape, how the lines are very distinct. There's no changing color throughout any of the object, so it'll be very easy for the vinyl cutter program to pick up. But if you're just wanting to be extra safe, or if you notice that there's an issue with part of the line contouring on the vinyl cut program, what you can do is you can actually save multiple images. So say one of our images, we need to make sure that there's all the lines for the black. So I can actually hide all of these and just show these layers so that I can figure out where the black lines are. The reason I needed to keep the blue was because we needed to make sure that it was able to say, yes, this is part of the cut line here. Because if I didn't include the blue, it would never cut that inner part. So this way I could drag this image into the program and I'd be able to actually get this part of the image to be the only part that gets cut, which is really cool. And you can do that for all of the different colors. So next, if I wanted to just cut the red parts, I can hide all of the layers except for the red part. And then if you make sure that the size of your image is the size that you want the vinyl cut to be, because you're not changing any of the sizes, you can drag all the images individually into the program, which makes it so you get very easy cut lines. If you guys have any more questions, you can always email the Maker Hub at makerhub@newmarketpl.ca. Or you can come in during the Maker Hub hours and we can help you out with any of the Adobe products or using the vinyl cutter, as well as some of the other cool technologies that we have here. Thank you guys, and I hope you all have a wonderful day.